Jujutsu Kaisen has a lot of strong characters, but few far in between compared to the likes of Gojo Satoru and Yuta Okkotsu. Both characters have extremely powerful abilities that allow them to completely outclass their opponents. While speaking of opponents, this really makes you wonder, what would happen if Gojo Satoru and Yuta Okkotsu were to face off against one another? In order to determine this, we'd have to understand how both of their powers work. Gojo Satoru is a special grade jujutsu shaman who specializes in using the limitless curse technique. This technique allows Satoru to become untouchable due to manipulating the space around him. Thanks to this, Satoru can slow down moving objects and create spaces that seem to suck in objects, which allows magnetic effects that wouldn't normally be possible to exist in the first place. For instance, Satoru can attract and repel space by manipulating his cursed energy. Through attraction, Satoru can take away the space in which something resides and completely focus it all into a single point at a time, or even move at incredible speeds by taking away the space that separates him from his current destination. In simpler terms, Satoru can even teleport under certain conditions. Using these abilities is also very tiring for Satoru, and to make up for this, Satoru had developed the reversal of his attraction technique, known as blue, by creating the reverse jujutsu, red, which does the complete opposite of the blue technique. Satoru can use reverse techniques on himself, which prevents him from ever tiring out. In doing so, Satoru has an impenetrable wall of space around him at all times that leaves him to be practically invincible, and this would normally tire Satoru out. But thanks to using the reversal technique, Satoru can keep his shield of infinity up as long as he wants and never have to focus on controlling his cursed energy in order to stop objects. Satoru would originally have to focus on whatever objects he wanted to stop, and this would exhaust him. But thanks to the reversal technique, Satoru can stop things automatically and never exhaust himself. This essentially makes Satoru have little to no openings for opponents to attack him, making him unstoppable. Satoru's strongest attack, purple, deletes the space in which anything resides, making it very easy to kill enemies with. This is possible due to Satoru combining both blue and red techniques. Anything Satoru aims at with purple becomes non-existent. Domain expansions will change the momentum of a fight in an instant. And Satoru's domain is no exception to this statement. When his domain is constructed, literally anyone caught in his domain will be unable to do anything because their mind will be stuck in an infinite loop of processing information. Simply put, when Satoru's domain is activated, you lose. Yuta Okkotsu, on the other hand, can unconditionally copy any curse technique and use it on the spot. This, combined with Yuta's endless amount of cursed energy, easily makes Yuta one of the strongest characters in Jujutsu Kaisen. This ability is so valuable because it allows Yuta to copy and perform techniques without having to learn them. For instance, Yuta can have an entire arsenal of cursed techniques that he has collected over the years and possibly have a cursed technique that could directly counter his opponent. We have seen how resourceful shamans are with just one cursed technique. Now imagine a shaman with multiple techniques. It would be as if you're fighting more than one person at a time. And this, combined with an endless supply of cursed energy, will allow Yuta to take any shaman's strongest attack and spam it as much as he wants with no drawbacks, such as getting tired. With this power, it is stated that Yuta could potentially rival Satoru and nearly defeat the entire Jujutsu company with a 99% win ratio.
If I were to fight for real, I'd maybe have a 30% chance of winning, I think. If the Jujutsu company came, it wouldn't even be 20%. But even for these unlikely numbers, there's a way to reach up to 99%. Just one. Kill Okkotsu Yuta and obtain a special class vengeful cursed spirit, Orimoto Rika.
Outside of its 1% chance of defeat, by just using Yuta's ability alone, the entire Jujutsu company would be utterly destroyed, thanks to Orimoto Rika. And even without Rika, the same effects are possible because Yuta's power is an endless amount of cursed energy that can be shaped at will. Yuta had just simply shaped his cursed energy into a form for Rika. With that being said, Rika is not the one who makes Yuta strong. Yuta is the one making Rika strong. This works because Yuta wanted his curse power to take Rika's form. And so, it can take any other form that Yuta wants because he can shape it at will. Even with such an amazing power, it really makes you wonder, how could Yuta even compare to Gojo Satoru in a battle? First off, Satoru has a territory, and from everything we know in the Jujutsu Kaisen manga, as of this video, Yuta does not have a territory. And with that being said, Satoru would win just by simply having his territory. But there's something in Yuta's favor. Even though Yuta does not have a territory that we know of, there is a possibility that he could still hold his own against Satoru in a fight, with the perfect counter to Satoru's territory. It was a technique to protect oneself from a territory. A territory of the weak. Shinkage style. Simple territory. A simple territory can be used to counter Gojo Satoru. A territory neutralizes all techniques. Inside a territory, an attack will hit anyone, even Gojo Satoru. With the possibility being open for Yuta to have copied a simple territory during his fight with Kyoto, we could come to the conclusion that he could also possess all the abilities of the Kyoto class as well. The chance boils down to 50%. However, it is more than likely that Yuta could have copied the simple territory technique from Miwa during the Goodwill event in Kyoto, where it said that Yuta had completely defeated Kyoto school in a one-sided affair. By obtaining the simple territory technique from Miwa, this would make up for Yuta's lack of a territorial or domain expansion. Now, if we compare Satoru's domain expansion to Yuta's simple territory, by following the rules of domain expansion, we could see who would win in a fight. The most effective counter to domain expansion is to expand your own. When multiple domains are expanded at the same time, the more polished one will remain supreme. With that being said, it's pretty obvious that Satoru's domain would reign supreme over Yuta's simple territory. However, that would be the case if we just took the claim of Satoru being the strongest and blew it out of proportion, without understanding the finer details. Being the strongest doesn't necessarily mean you can't be beat. As stated before, Yuta Okkotsu can copy any cursed technique unconditionally. And this brings the question, can Yuta copy Satoru's ability? So is there anyone other than Gojo, the strongest character in the manga, who can use Limitless? The answer is yes. However, Limitless is extremely difficult to use and requires a sophisticated manipulation of cursed energy. Even though there are other sorcerers with the possibility of using the Limitless Curse technique, Satoru Gojo is the only one who can use it because he possesses a special eye. With this information from the creator of Jujutsu Kaisen, we can come to the conclusion that Yuta can copy Satoru's ability. Although Yuta is able to use the Limitless, he can't because he does not have the eye. When it comes to Yuta's possibilities in terms of using the Limitless without the eye, it opens more possibilities as to how it can be used without the eye. Could we see a substitute for the eye? Or could Yuta possibly develop his own techniques with the Limitless? These are all possibilities to take into consideration. Yuta's copying ability would not get him far in a fight against Satoru. But there's another way for Yuta to fight back Satoru. Yuta Okkotsu. Huh. I don't get what everyone sees in him. His ability to unconditionally copy curse techniques when multiple domains are expanded at the same time. The more polished one will reign supreme. It can also depend on compatibility and cursed energy, and his boundless cursed energy. In a battle of domains, Yuta can completely overwhelm Satoru with the simple territory technique that he has copied, all thanks to his endless cursed energy. In a battle of domains, Satoru would run out of energy, for his domain, especially since performing a domain or territorial expansion takes a lot of energy. Constructing a domain uses a ton of cursed energy, but can be worth it. Yuta will not have to suffer from loss of energy to his simple territory, unlike Satoru, and with his endless energy, Yuta's simple territory will never lose its potency, and while being in Yuta's territory, Satoru will be defenseless. A territory neutralizes all techniques. Satoru will not be able to use the infinity or any other techniques while inside of Yuta's simple territory, meaning he will not be able to fight back against Yuta. Inside a territory, an attack will hit anyone, even Gojo Satoru. To put this in the simplest way possible, if Yuta were to use his own domain or a simple territory against Satoru, he would completely outclass him due to the infinite amount of cursed energy supplying his domain or territory. In a battle of peak Jujutsu, Yuta Okkotsu can completely defeat Gojo Satoru.